Hi, my name is Mark Wasserman. I'm a senior mechanical engineering major. And my role with Base 11 is I am part of the propulsion team working on the engine and test stand.
Hi, my name is Kathleen Jocelyn. I'm a student here at Portland State University, and my major is mathematics. My role in the Base 11 Space Challenge is team lead of the liquid fuel engine.
My name is Risto. I am a Master's of Systems Engineering student, and I am the PSAS Chief Engineer for the Base 11 team.
Hi, this is Dashnika. My major is Engineering and Technology Management, and I'm the Chief Safety Officer at PSAS.
My name is Gabe. I am a Physics Mechanical Engineering double major with a minor in Space and Planetary Science, and I am part of the LV-4 Advanced Airframe Concepts Engineering team. My specific role is Test Engineer.
My name is Corey Gillette. I am a Mathematics major, and my role on PSAS's Base 11 team is helping with the conceptual design of LV-4.
My name is Jean-Pierre Pellet. I am a third-year mechanical engineering student here at Portland State University. I am the Launch Vehicle 3 Vehicle Manager for Portland State Aerospace Society, which is our testbed sounding rocket for our Base 11 rocket.
The Base 11 Space Challenge competition is going extremely well. I'm really excited to apply myself to something like the Base 11 Challenge, primarily because it overlaps in so many ways. From a business perspective, it allows me to grow experience and new knowledge.
The most challenging aspect of the competition has actually been that we've learned a lot about how the various systems should work and work together, and that's forced us to go and look back at some of our old designs that we already had coming into the competition, and realizing that we actually need to redo a lot of it.
My love for the subject. There is nothing better than the robotry, the aerospace engineering, and it's that love and that passion that keeps me going.
The most interesting and fun part is the depth of knowledge that we gain about specific things such as design practices, design softwares, using 3D experience, as well as Onshape, SolidWorks, all these different things, because we get taught about them in school, but only mildly. And so to try and take that surface level knowledge and use it to create something real while still being in school is a really awesome thing.
An interesting thing I've noticed, it's been mentioned before, is that we know how to work with what we have. Because we don't get a lot of funding, PSAS has to work with a limited amount of supplies.
I would say that there's likely a non-zero probability that we win the competition, but from a frequentist interpretation of probability, I can't actually say much since there's no sample size.
We are really confident because we are a group of a bunch of passionate people, and we just love being here, so we are space nuts and we will do it.
I think even if we don't win the challenge, it's been a really worthwhile endeavor, and I think it's pushed the group to work faster, to iterate more, and to really reach.
I have encountered some people, like especially around the business school, who don't understand what my interest is in space.
I would think that most of my friends and family don't quite understand what it is that I'm doing, except something something rocket science, something something never see him anymore.
Most of my siblings don't know what I'm talking about for the most part, but that's okay. They seem to be proud, and then my peers, of course, all of my friends are in PSAS, so.
My parents are pretty ecstatic about me doing rocket stuff. My dad's an engineer, so he gets to nerd out with me.
Most of my peers are either already involved or are actively looking for ways to join PSAS as well.
When I talk to my friends about PSAS and Base 11, they're like, okay, fine, yeah, she is always into space stuffs, and yeah, she's doing it